John chapter 18 from verse 33 to 38. John chapter 18, that is the gospel according to Saint John chapter 18. John chapter 18, right. We will see what he's talking about there. So I'm going to read it for you from verse 33. John 18 verse 33. So why did Jesus say, my kingdom is not of this world? Now let's look. Jesus was answering the question of Pilate, the guy who condemned him to death, that was Pilate. So then Pilate entered the praetorium again, called Jesus and said to him, are you the king of the Jews? So he was provoking Jesus. He was saying, okay, the Jews have brought you to me to crucify you because they said, you claim that you are their king. You claim that the Jewish nation is your kingdom. You claim that you are the king of that kingdom. And your people, the people that you call your dominion, your kingdom, have said they don't want you to be their king. They are the ones who brought you to me that I should kill you, I should crucify you because they don't want you to be their king. So Pilate was challenging Jesus and telling Jesus, did you say you are the king of the Jews? But it's the same Jews who have brought you, it's the same kingdom that you say you are representing that have come here, and they said they are, you are not their king and they don't want you. So Jesus now says, Jesus answered him in verse 34, are you speaking to yourself about this, or did others tell you this concerning me? So Jesus was challenging him. This was an intellectual duel, intellectual discussion, intellectual fight, wrestling going on. And Jesus was saying, did they tell you this, that I said I am the king of the Jews? Or it is just your thought that, you know, you are just saying this by yourself, that, you know, I am the king of the Jews. Pilate answered, am I a Jew like you? Your own nation, you see, your own kingdom. That word nation there is referring to the kingdom as well. Your own nation, your own kingdom, and the chief priests of your nation have delivered you to me to kill you. What have you done if you are not claiming that you are the king? So what have you done? Jesus answered, he said, listen, my kingdom is not of this world. My kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, my servants would fight so that I should not be delivered to the Jews. But now my kingdom is not from here. Underline the word from here. Underline the word from here. Because if people are, you know, who say that we should not be advancing the kingdom, that, you know, that we should not bring the kingdom of God here, that we should just separate ourselves and try to go to heaven, that the only thing Christians should be doing is to make heaven, that, you know, we should just try to go to heaven and go to the kingdom of God because Jesus even said his kingdom is out of this world, so we should leave the world, let the world die, let things happen to the world, anything, you know, the world is going to hell anyway. So Jesus said his kingdom is not of this world, you know, we shouldn't go to the casinos, we shouldn't go to the cinemas, we shouldn't go to evangelize people there, we shouldn't, because the world is dying anyway, we should not fix the economy. And people are using this argument why the Christians are not going to fix the economy. They use this argument why Christians are not going to politics. They use this argument as the reason why Christians are not going to win the world of culture, entertainment. They use this argument why we are not taking the kingdom of God to all the spheres of life, why our country is going to hell and our country is deteriorating, and we say we Christians cannot do anything. So everybody is just saying this world is going to hell anyway, and Jesus said his kingdom is not of this world. If his kingdom is not of this world, we also cannot do anything. We should just let everything go, let everything get spoiled, let everything get destroyed. And But I am preaching that it is the opposite. That the dream in the heart of God is that we, you know, God intended that the kingdom of God will come to the earth. Let thy kingdom come. Let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That it is God's dream that the earth will reflect heaven. That the earth, the life on the earth, the, you know, an atmosphere, the ambience on the earth will reflect the ambience and the atmosphere in heaven, in the kingdom of God. That it's our mandate, it is our calling to make sure that we bring the atmosphere of heaven here, that we bring the reality of heaven here. So if in heaven there is righteousness, righteousness must be here. If in heaven there is peace, peace must be here. If in heaven there is joy, joy must be here. If they said there will be no tears in heaven. If there are no tears in heaven, we should try our best to wipe people's tears here on earth. If there is no pain in heaven, we should try our best to relieve people of their pain here on earth as well. If the heaven is full of gold and the earth and they walk on the streets of gold, we should also do our best to make the earth beautiful as well. If not as beautiful as walking on the street of gold, at least to make it presentable. Our nation should be presentable. Our nation should be wonderful. Our nation should be beautiful. Our economy should be prosperous. Our politics should be orderly. The order of God, the rule of God. If God is a God of order, godliness, there should be order in our society. There should be order in our politics. There should be order in our society. There should be righteousness everywhere. There should be godliness everywhere. If God is a God of perfection, there must be perfection. We should try to have perfection in everything we do. We should have the best products. We should have the best economy, the best roads, the best parks, the best trees, the best forest, the best oxygen, the best air, the best ecology, the best oceans, the best rivers, the best beaches. You know, we should do things so that the earth will be at least resemblant to the to heaven. Our places of work, our places of passion, our places of calling, our mountains of influence, we should work hard to make them to look like heaven. We should work hard to make that there is order of God. We should make sure that all kind of disorderliness goes. We should make sure and work towards the fact that all kind of chaos leave our society. Because there is no chaos in heaven. Since there is no chaos in heaven, we should try to get rid of chaos here as well. There is no disorderliness in heaven. We should try to get rid of this orderliness. There is all kind of destruction, discomfort, and others. So we should also try to get rid of these things. That is what Jesus did. When he came to the earth, he made sure that he was pushing back the territories of hell. Satan is the destroyer. Satan is the one that comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. So everything that is stealing, that is killing, that is destroying, is not the kingdom of heaven. That is what Satan does. And that is what Satan is doing on the earth. Satan is trying to bring destruction and to steal things from us. He wants to steal our health. He wants to steal our wealth. He wants to steal our prosperity. He wants to steal our peace. He wants to steal our righteousness. He wants to steal our harmony. He wants to steal the order in our society. That's what Satan wants to do. He wants to kill us. He wants to kill our health. He wants to kill our families. He wants to kill our children. He wants to kill our husbands, our spouses. He wants to do all that kind of thing. He wants to bring destruction to our politics, to our economy, to our social life, to our culture. So he wants to bring disorder, tears, pain, confusion. That is the work of Satan. And the work of God is the opposite. The kingdom of God is a kingdom of perfection. The kingdom of God is a kingdom of order. The kingdom of God is a kingdom where all tears have been wiped away. The kingdom of God is a kingdom of peace. It's a kingdom of joy. It's a kingdom where there is no confusion, no disorder, no tears, no pain. This is the kingdom of God. And this is what Jesus brought us, and that was the original intention in the heart of God originally. He wanted the earth to be a copy, a replica of the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven is our prototype, and we are supposed to duplicate it. That is what our life is supposed to be about. And so when the religious people talk, they said, no, let the world just be the way it was, and let just leave the earth to Satan, that Satan is the one here. No, it's not just Satan that is here. Yes, Satan is here on the earth. We are also here on the earth. We are God's children. We are kingdom representatives. We represent the kingdom of God. We carry the kingdom of God in us. We shouldn't leave the earth to Satan. We shouldn't let Satan take over. We shouldn't let Satan take authority and bring his destruction, his chaos, and his catastrophe to every sphere of life. We should be pushing back Satan. We should be taking back territories from Satan through the righteousness of God, through the orderliness of God, through the peace of God, through the joy of the kingdom of God, through the vast truth and reality of the kingdom of God. We should be pushing back Satan from everywhere where he's reigning right now. And that is what Jesus came to do. He did that himself. The disciples did the same thing. And we are called to be responsible to a certain sphere of life where we are also pushing back Satan, pushing back the territories of hell, and bringing the reality of the kingdom of God. That the earth will be able to examine, taste, have a taste of the kingdom of God. That the love of the kingdom will come to the people's life. That the kindness of the kingdom will come to people's life. That the meekness of the kingdom, the temperance of the kingdom, that the goodness of the kingdom will be experienced by other people. And that is why Jesus brought the kingdom of God. Hello everybody, DSA here. I would like us to spread this word together. Let the gospel of the kingdom conquer the world. We only need you to help us take 5 simple steps. What are these steps? 1, go ahead and like the video, please, if you have not yet done that. Number 2, we need you to subscribe to this channel. Have you yet subscribed? Not yet done it? Go do it now. Number 3, you need to press and click on that bell. You see the bell there? That will give you notification of every video that we do. Then the next thing you need to do, write your comments. Let's know what you think, good or bad. And then, of course, you have other platforms like Instagram, like Facebook. Share this video on your other platforms. All right? Let's win the word for Christ. Peace.